So I think this is a conversation that we have put off for a very long time. It seems so obvious, and yet we don't find the time consciously to sit down and talk about our health with our mothers. So what does your mother's health say about yours? So why is this discussion relevant? It's because mothers and daughters naturally share everything from family recipes to boss lady skills. But have you ever had a discussion with your mother about her present health or her past health? And while half of your genes come from your dad, your mom's DNA and her health experience, particularly her female health-related issues, can affect your risk for the same conditions. So her answers to your questions could help you become more empowered about your health. You don't just look like her, or you don't just share her skills in dance or something else. You also share genetics. So it's important to start talking, even though some issues may be uncomfortable to discuss. So what is our aim for starting this conversation? It's that there are some things in the risk factors of a disease that you can change and you cannot change. For instance, you can change your lifestyle habits, or you could change your diet, or you could change a certain factor in your physical activity, but you can't change genetics. So our aim to talk to our moms is so that we can develop a personalized prevention program for yourself, depending on what risk factors you presently have, so that you can start to make those lifestyle changes, which would prevent you from developing a certain condition, so that you can start testing at an early age, so that you get diagnosed at an early stage of the disease, and so you can use medicines or surgical treatments to prevent the disease. So we can't alter genetics, but we can affect the other risk factors that cause the disease. Next, the first most simplest question is age at menopause. If your mother has had menopause, so the questions you would ask is, when did you reach menopause and what was it like for you? In what was it like for you, she could probably tell you the symptoms she went through, like if she had hot flashes, if she had back pain, if she had mood swings, if she suffered from depression. And these could give you an idea of what symptoms to expect and how you could manage those. So the age at which you enter menarche or start menstruation, and the age at which you stop menstruating or enter menopause, are determined 50% by genetics and 50% by non-genetic factors. So there's a lion's share that genetics play in this. Now, why is that important? It's because the age at which your mother experienced menopause is just gives you an idea of how many years of fertility you have left, so that you can start planning a family or just think about it, considering the future in general. If your mother has reached menopause under the age of 40, there's a high chance that a big role has been played by genetics. And if that is the case, it's a good idea to know if your mother, besides your mother, if your grandmother or your sisters or your aunts have also experienced the same thing. Factors that won't affect the age of menopause is when you started menstruating. That's not going to change when you get menopause. If you've breastfed, a lot of patients assume that because I've not ovulated when I'm breastfeeding, I will reach menopause at a later stage. That is not true. PCOS, taking oral contraceptive pills, none of these affect the age at which you reach menopause. And so what can we do about this is we can take a look at the factors that do affect menopause, like smoking, any surgeries on your ovaries, any chemotherapy or radiation exposure to your ovaries, and we can work on modifying these factors. For instance, if you're smoking, you cut down on the smoking, make lifestyle changes, like make sure you cut down your alcohol use. And if you've had surgeries, then you plan in advance for whatever symptoms of menopause you could expect basis your mother. The biggest question to ask your mother is, have you had any mammogram or breast cancer screening? I would say this right now. If she hasn't, if the answer to this question has been no, please make sure she gets one ASAP. Almost 30% of all breast cancers are due to genetics, which means 30% of patients will have a mother, an aunt, a grandmother, or a sister who has had it before them. The more relatives you have, the higher your risk. And the risk nearly doubles in a woman if her mother has had it. So there are two genes that play a role in this. That's the BRCA or Barker gene 1 and the Barker gene 2. So anyone who has a mutated gene, BRCA1 or 2, has a 50 to 85% risk of developing breast and ovarian cancer. So not just breast cancers, even ovarian cancers are passed on from female relatives, female blood relatives. And you, if somebody in your family has it, it's a good idea to get checked and get screened. So what can you do about it? If you know that anyone in your family or your mother, most importantly, has a mutated BRCA gene, then you start, you mention it to your doctor first. And secondly, you start getting more screenings, something that you can do yourself. And you can also ask your mother to do is self-examination. We tell patients to examine themselves in the shower. Look for any swellings or lumps in your breast. Look for any swellings or lumps in your armpit. And the moment you notice one, go get it checked. It's never a bad idea. There are also certain factors that affect the risk of breast cancer besides genetics that can work together with genetics and increase your risk even more. And that's hormone replacement therapy. That's alcohol intake is contributory, even women with higher weights. So make sure that if you have a mutated gene that you want to try and avoid hormone replacement therapy, we always encourage breastfeeding. It is protective against breast cancer to a certain extent. So make sure you do that and keep your weight and alcohol intake in check. The risk for heart disease. So questions you could ask your mom around this is, are you being treated for high blood pressure? Are you being treated for high blood cholesterol? Does she have a minor heart condition that you don't know of? Now, while most of us are living with our moms, if you aren't, if you're working outside, you could also ask your mothers about medication, about what were the medications that were used for her to get a better idea of what is the cause for her high blood pressure or what is the cause for her heart condition. So your risk is almost up by 20% if your mother has had this. And if your mother has had a blood vessel disease and not just a heart disease, if her high blood pressure is because of a blood vessel disease, then it's likely that blood vessels all over the body are going to be impacted. So her risk for stroke and your risk for stroke also goes up. And that's something you should be knowing and telling your practitioner. So heart disease and its risk factors, such as high blood pressure or obesity or alcohol intake or high cholesterol, are strongly linked to family history. So you could work with your doctor to reduce all of these risk factors. And what you can do in the meanwhile is maintain a healthy weight, eat food low in fat, in saturated fat and salt, don't smoke, and keep your alcohol consumption to a minimum. What can I do for my mom? So far we've just spoken about what health history you could extract from your mom. And now she's at an age where you could definitely be proactive about her health and you could get a lot of things done for her. Let's talk about those. The first thing is get a yearly preventive screen or a well health checkup or a well woman checkup for your mother. Make sure she gets a pap smear every 5 years until she reaches the age of 65. Make sure that she gets a mammogram and a breast exam after the age of 30. And make sure that she does talk to her about getting self-breast exams. You could assess the risk that she has for osteoporosis. So you could get her bone mineral density checked via a DEXA scan. You could also get her vitamin D and calcium levels checked. Talking about vitamin deficiencies, if your mother's a vegetarian, you could get her B12 checked. You could get her hemoglobin checked, assess her risk for diabetes and hypertension. You could not just talk to her about maintaining a good lifestyle and avoiding all these things, but make sure you include it in your yearly preventive screening. And if she's already on certain treatments, make sure that she does her follow-up visits and gets her prescriptions renewed. If the medicines are not working for her, that she gets alternate medicines or modifies her doses accordingly. I think that's what you can do for your mom. You can also check in on her mental health. If your mother is going through menopause, it's hard. So if she needs help around it, this could be a good time you start checking in on her. Now, this is something which you can do like a homework. You can make a disease family tree. Where you can just sort of write down which member in your family, and we are talking about immediate family, blood relatives only, which member in your family has a certain condition. So if you could, you know, figure out if your mother's mother had something, your uncle doesn't have it, but your mother has it, then there is a certain pattern of inheritance to it. So you could possibly be developing it for all the women who have joined us today. And you can identify and modify your risk factors if you are having these risks, like if you are seeing a certain pattern.